When scripting in Unity, sometimes we want a variable that is one of a set of constants. Consider the points of a compass. We could describe these using an integer where 0 was north, 1 was east, 2 was south, and 3 was west. This wouldn't be very easy to read or write in code since it would mean remembering what each number referred to. Instead, we can create something called an enumeration. Enumerations, which are often referred to as enums, are a special data type that has a specific subset of possible values. Here, we have a script named cardinal direction. Let's create an enumeration to represent the different directions of a compass. We can create the enumeration either inside or outside of a class. Note that we can also create a C# script that only contains this enum, and instead of declaring this as a class, we've declared it as an enum. We could then use this enum in classes that live in other scripts because it's public. We could place an enum in a class if only that class needed access to it. We need to list the various constants of the enum separated by commas in braces. First, we want north, then east, south, and finally west. Unlike when you normally close braces, this is the end of a statement and so needs a semicolon. Each of the constants declared in this enum has a value which by default is an integer counting up from 0. This is integrated through the set, so north has a value of 0, east has a value of 1, south has a value of 2, and west has a value of 3. Both the type of value and the values themselves can be overridden if required. If we were to declare the enum with north equals 1, then east would have a value of 2, south a value of 3, and west a value of 4. Alternatively, we could declare a value for each of the constants, such as north equals 10, east equals 11, south equals 15, and west equals 27, for example. We can also change the type of constants in an enum. The constants can be changed to any integral type. We change the type by putting a colon after the name of our enum and putting the type afterwards. For example, we could have direction colon short. This would mean that the type of the enum was short instead of int. One of the main reasons for changing the type of an enum is optimization, but generally we won't worry about it. Once we have our enum declared, we then make variables of the enum's type. Let's make a direction variable called myDirection. We now can treat this just like any other variable, but whereas an integer might have a value of 5 or a float might have a value of 97.3, our myDirection variable can have values of direction.north, direction.east, direction.south, or direction.west. Let's set myDirection to direction.north in the start function. Our enum can also be parsed into and returned from functions. We simply use the name of the enum, in our case direction, where we would use a type. To illustrate this, let's make a small function to reverse a given direction. Given north, it should return south, and so on. The return type for our function is direction, and we'll call the function reverse direction. We'll give the function a direction parameter, which we'll call dir, and return the opposite. Now, all we need to do is compare dir to our various direction constants. We only need to check for north, east, south, and west, because those are the only possible values.